Hello guys, I hope y'all are having a awesome Thursday. So this is another one of my special occasion dresses. So this one is a mermaid dress. I made this one a while ago. Yeah, I made this one a while ago. So it's made like a mermaid. Hi Gino, you want to say hi? Gino want to say hi? Gino, you say hi? Okay. So this one is made like a mermaid with the sweetheart top. So it's got the sweetheart. So how I wound up making this, I made the sweetheart piece, the dress. I connected it, and then I got all the way down to like right above the knee, and then I did a. If it'll come out right, you know. Wait a second. Wait a second. It is like a. I should have put the petticoat on with this one, but it's like a circle. But then I did it the back a little bit longer than the front, if y'all can see. So the back is a little bit longer than the front. And I do have a petticoat that you can wear under this. So this, how many yards? I think I had about 4 yards of this. 4 yards of this fabric. But yeah, so this is another one of the special occasion dresses. So this one will be like, you know, something that mother of the bride or something like that will wear. So I'm doing trying to do like all these different dresses and stuff like that. Gino. So yeah, so that's what I've been doing behind the scenes. I've been really working hard and facing my fears. I got another project that I'm gonna show y'all where, you know, when you have something that you don't make and you have the fear. So my fear is making like now sweethearts and stuff. I really don't fear that because that's kind of easy. But now I'm getting into making the corset tops, but with the bra cups in them. So the challenge for me when you making that, like you gotta have the right breast cups, because if you get the wrong breast cups, it will not work. So what I've learned, and a lot of women, we don't know our bra size. And a lot of times we wear bras that's too little. So to be honest, I really don't like bras. I like sports bras or no bras. So I'm not really a bra person. So I have some of them, but when a lot of time when women wear their bras and you see all that additional skin, that mean that we are in the wrong size bra. When I remember going to Victoria's Secret a while ago and they did the measurements and she said, "You can't fit any bras in here." And I'm like, "Huh? I always buy bras out of here." And she said, "Yeah, you probably do buy bras out of here, but you're not wearing the correct size. Like how we do measurements for bras, you wouldn't measure at any of these bras. You will have to go to our online store." Where they go and they go into the double D's and triple D's and E's and D. I'm like, huh? So yes, so you know, so that was something like when it come to making that, I have a fear of that because not knowing if I have the right cup size. So I'm working on this dress right here. Let me show y'all. Okay, so I'm challenging myself. Let me level it up. So I see this dress, and if you see the shapes that's cut out, that's gonna be for the bra. But I actually need the other mannequin next to this one because it's my size. But these is the bra cups that's gonna go in this corset top. So, but like I was telling you guys, like let me, I have a challenge. I have a challenge with trying to. Dude, now I got it down too low. I have a challenge with, you know, getting the right bra cups and stuff like that. So when I got this bra cup and you put it on there or whatever, and then the boning and all that, I'm figuring like this would be a good bra cup, but I'm not, to be honest, to be absolutely honest, I'm not for sure. And then sometimes when they bring out some of those bras and they be huge, big old, and I'm like, I don't want that. Like, I do not want that. If some of it had a padding and it looked even more wonky and crazy, and I'd be like, I don't want that. So I'm learning to face my fears and I'm challenging myself to to do stuff or make something that I'm not comfortable with, because how can you get good at something if you won't even challenge yourself to do it? First thing, I'd be like, oh no, in my mind, I ain't gonna get it right. So I just will opt out of doing it. So I'm doing now, learning that, because like I said, everything I've learned, guys, I learned from a book. I learned from a book and I learned from online. I never had an instructor. I never had a teacher. So that's something that I'm challenging myself. But I've learned that, like they were saying to a lot of women, we don't know our bra size. And we get the wrong size a lot of the time. And we will force ourselves into these sizes, and meaning, you know, we thinking that's the size. But in true sizes and people that really make the bras and all that, we don't be wearing the right size. So I'm not even for sure if those cups is right, because like I said, a lot of stuff don't do the lift, but it just probably just give you just the coverage. Like probably just, I would say just will go over, and you know, when I put it on and a boning, because I don't got boning in this one, but when you put it on and a boning, so you know, it probably just get them in there like this, and I'll be like, oh, okay, that's perfect. And in reality, that's not. So yeah, I'm working on a lot of different stuff, guys. So I will show y'all in the next video. So this one won't be so long. But this dress, I did my half scale mannequin. And these dresses are going to be different. The other one on the mannequin is a sweetheart. But the one that I'm actually going to do, y'all see that I'm, you know, getting prepared. But I need the other mannequin. So in order to get the perfect fit, that wedding dress that I'm still working on, still waiting on the pearl tool to come, and still got to stitch a couple things. So that dress need to come off of that mannequin, and I move to the side while I go and put this one on that, because I actually need those shapes to be able to get me that 39 inches. So I wouldn't do it on this one. So just trying to get the space. So that's what I'm working on, guys. So thanks for listening. Toodles.